look here. We want to show you what people are going to see on their morning and evening commutes in New York City. You're going to see the National Guard here standing here along with state police and more law enforcement. 750 National Guardsmen and 250 New York State troopers are being deployed into the subway system. That's in addition to the 1,000 NYPD officers that were added into the transit system in February. Along with the extra manpower, NYPD officers will also conduct random bag checks, we're told.
Chicago Mayor Brandon Johnson was asked earlier this week if the National Guard might be a solution for crime on the CTA. Johnson says it's not his decision.
The National Guard, that's under the jurisdiction of the governor of Illinois, right? So all I can say is what I am responsible for.
Hill says the police have their hands full in this town. It says half the people arrested for an incident on a bus or an L train are already wearing ankle monitors, indicating they've been in the system, but nothing stops them from becoming a threat again.
My drivers feel helpless. We feel like we're sitting ducks. And even when the police come and do arrest somebody, we pick up the same person the next day.
So the globalist CIA New World Order Combine is openly preparing civil war and martial law in America and rolling out troops on the streets, as I told you they would out of this. I think everybody agrees that's been paying attention that I am the police state New World Order martial law expert. Only because I'm 20 years old and they've got black helicopters flying around in Round Rock and San Antonio blowing up buildings at night, and people I know have seen it, and then the newspapers say it isn't existing, and then my cousin saw them in Houston blowing up like three floors of a building at night. And this is in like 1994 when I was first getting on air, and I'm like covering it, and there's suddenly articles about me in the paper saying he's crazy, he believes in black helicopters. So I make some phone calls, check with some family, they go, yeah, that's Delta Force, they're doing training. Well, then why was the media denying it? So then I learned about Bill Clinton, and it came out in the news that they were having surveys, the Marine Corps, will you confiscate guns? And then a few years later, they start publicly training the military to confiscate guns, and it's in mainstream news. And then with Obama and then Bush before that, we see Katrina and clergy response teams that are the preachers trained to tell people to go turn their guns in. And we learned about this giant submerged iceberg that we just learned about the tip of.
Life became a surveillance grid nightmare, with every individual's actions ruthlessly catalogued and recorded by the state. Secret arrests, checkpoints, and warrantless searches spread. The final incremental march of the police state, culminating in open martial law. This is the story of how the elite sold their people into slavery.
You know, I just played just a little intro, a little promo clip of a new video I've got coming out early next year, Martial Law, 9/11, Rise of the Police State. And it's about the Bush, Schwarzenegger, Nazi connection, about the police state in New York, and the newest 9/11 revelation. So it really gives you a picture of who these thugs are that run our country, who they work for, and the type of world that they are creating and setting up.
And there was this big move for martial law in America. And when they set up TSA after 9/11, they said, soon we're going to have it at bus stations and train stations and subways and highways. And that was officially the original rollout plan, but they were beta testing.
Are you starting to get what it's like to be a human and have humanity and face just that we are Nazi Germany? You go, well, if that's the case, why are you still on the air? Because it's all an illusion. It's meant to make everybody think it's normal so they can get along with it, so they can condition us. They've got to put the control grid in and then go after people like me.
And I said, you know when they're getting ready to really drop the hammer, and I've said this a lot the last year, when they start putting troops domestically in Chicago is the first place I guess they would do it. So I said, when you see troops called out in Chicago, New York, Los Angeles, by the Democrats, for the crime they've created and instigated with the open borders and almost every prosecutor controlled by Soros, letting hardened criminals out, letting rapists out, he got the IMF World Bank document from Whistleblower, and they said, the first thing we do is defund police and then have prosecutors let criminals go. We let that go for about 5 years on average, then everything's destroyed and falls apart. Then we put in law and order groups after it, declare martial law, and all the value goes back up and we get it that way. This is very sophisticated fifth generational warfare, and it's being scientifically applied and beta tested, but now again, they're going into operational.
Look at the climate around you. We're all being treated like slaves by those who, in truth, are the terrorists.
While other networks lie to you about what's happening now, InfoWars tells you the truth about what's happening next.
Visit Infowars.com/show and support the Infowars.